Hello. In this WAGO tutorial, we will show how to enable communication between devices and transfer values in Building Network Backnet using the client mapping function. WAGO provides the software WAGO Backnet Configurator for the commissioning, configuration, and management of backnet networks and devices. This software can be downloaded free of charge from the WAGO Download Center. A link is provided in the video description. If the WAGO Solution Builder add-on and the WAGO Backnet Configurator are installed, the latter can be opened from the CODESYS 3.5 development environment. However, for client mapping, the Backnet Configurator also functions as a standalone application and can be opened directly via the desktop icon. Client mapping is an easy way to switch an actuator with a sensor, as it runs directly in the Backnet stack and does not require a development environment like CODESYS 3.5. We will use the simple sensor actuator example in this tutorial. However, with client mapping, you can read or write everything: inputs, outputs, values, variables, properties, status flags, and so on. Client mapping is not limited to sensors and actuators and can be applied to all Backnet devices. Every Backnet device has multiple objects. Each object has various properties. Which objects and properties are compatible with a WAGO Backnet device is described in the so-called PIX table. A link to the WAGO PIX tables is provided in the video description. Here is the PIX table for the controller we use in this video. Let's scroll to the binary input object to the list of all inputs properties. The most interesting property for this video is the present value, which indicates the current state of the input, either true or false. Here we see that we can only read the present value, which is functionally correct for an input. In the binary output object, however, the present value can also be written. All objects and properties listed in the PIX can be processed by our Backnet controller. It also follows that objects or properties not listed here cannot be used by this controller in client mapping at this time. All properties within the scope of the conformity listed here can be linked with properties of other objects or devices. For this video, we use a very small Backnet network consisting of a CC100 with Backnet activated and licensed and a Backnet coupler 750-332. Connected to the coupler is an 8-channel digital input terminal, an analog input module, and of course the end module 600. Both Backnet devices are in the same subnet. The WAGO Backnet Configurator can recognize the coupler with all connected modules and consequently the corresponding Backnet objects. This is not the case with the CC100, so it is advised to first create a CODESYS 3.5 project and start the WAGO Backnet Configurator from there. This allows the appropriate Backnet objects for the hardware inputs and outputs to be created, linked, and transferred to the WAGO Backnet Configurator. A detailed tutorial on this process is part of the tutorial Backnet Configurator Setup in CODESYS 3.5. A link is provided in the video description. In the WAGO Backnet Configurator, both devices are found. We must add both devices to the database. By right-clicking, we can select Add to Database and first load the CC100 into the database and then the coupler. Everything is now prepared for client mapping. In the first example, we want to switch the first digital output of the CC100 with the first digital input of the coupler. This can be done in the client mapping using two different methods: the preferred read map function and the write map function. The read function is inherently more robust than the write function. With the read function, the client initially subscribes to a specific value from the server, making the client a subscriber. When the subscribed value changes, the server sends the value to the client. Additionally, the subscription is only valid for a certain time and is regularly renewed. Due to this system of subscribing, notifying, and resubscribing, the read function is very robust and quickly updated even after a device restart. The write function, on the other hand, works one-dimensionally. The server sends the telegram upon value change without client feedback. we start with the read function in client mapping. The CC100 acts as the client that wants to read a value, and the BACnet coupler serves as the server from which the client requests the value. We want to use the read function to switch the DO1 of the CC100 via the DI1 of the coupler. To do this, right-click on the CC100 to open the Configure tab. Since we want to switch the DO1 on the CC100, go to Outputs, open the tree with the plus sign and select the first binary output. In the table on the right, we find the column client mappings. Clicking in the present value field in the client mappings column opens the client mapping editor. Here we map the output of the CC100 to the input of the coupler. To do this, open the inputs of the coupler and find the needed present value in the binary input 0 tree. With the add read map button, we link the two properties using the read function. Now we can configure a few settings. In the right area are the read map settings. There are two different ways to query the value. One option is COV, which stands for change of value. When the value changes, the server notifies the client and the client reads the value. This method has the advantage of only using bus bandwidth and controller computing power when relevant data is available. The other method is polling, where the client cyclically queries the current value of the input. The cycle time is preset to 3 seconds. The longer the cycle time, the less data traffic on the bus. In a BACnet network with hundreds of devices, each with multiple objects polling various properties, a 3-second cycle can quickly overload the bus. Therefore, the COV method is preferred. In the Use Subscription field, we can select the method, always uses COV exclusively, while never uses only polling. If available, first attempts to subscribe to the value on the server by sending a subscribe COV telegram. If this fails, polling is used. The client's subscription to a property on the server expires after a defined period and must be requested again. This period can be specified at COV expiry. The default value is 120 seconds. After half the time, the client sends a new subscribe COV telegram. If this is not confirmed, the mapping expires after the set COV expiry time. Request confirm notification. Here, you can select whether a COV notification from the server is confirmed by the client. If this option is selected, the server expects a confirmation from the client after sending the COV notification. If this feedback does not arrive, the server resends the COV notification. Generally, this function remains disabled as it can significantly increase bus load and should only be used consciously. Read property multiple. Read property multiple consolidates all active read client mappings on the device into a single read property multiple telegram. Connection monitoring. Connection monitoring is a cyclic monitoring function for a connection between BACnet objects and devices. When enabled, the BACnet device monitors the status of client mapping connections by cyclically querying the properties, status, time of device restart, and database revision from the server's device object. The query occurs every 60 seconds. Monitoring allows timely signaling of a connection interruption before a polling interval has elapsed or a COV subscription renewal is needed. If a connection interruption occurs, the communication failure message is displayed in the reliability property. The reliability property is only available from the medium object size. We check the box to test this function later. To test the read function, we need to close the editor window. With store and download, we save the settings and upload them to the controller. In the input properties of the first digital input on the coupler, we can see how the present value switches to true as soon as we apply 24 volts to the input. Switching to the digital output on the CC100, we see how it also reflects the true or false state. The hardware output can also be switched through the coupler input. Just the same, analog values can be subscribed by using the read function, but a threshold must be defined to determine the magnitude of the value change. Without this threshold, any minor change would send a COV telegram, potentially overloading the field bus quickly. The threshold for the read function is set on the server, in our case, the coupler. Under inputs, analog inputs, we find the property COV increment. Here we can specify, for example, a value of 0.1, meaning the value change must be at least 0.1 before being sent to the CC100 that has subscribed to this value. Since a COV increment of 0 fundamentally carries the risk of network overload, the COV increment is also evaluated and displayed as a warning during the configuration check. Even if the BACnet project initially runs reliably, unexpected high loads can occur on the BACnet network when expansions or connections to a building management system are made. Therefore, we always recommend entering a technically meaningful value here, even if the value is not initially used. All COV subscribers on a server are shown in the property Active COV Subscriber found in the device object at the top. With the plus sign, the subscribed values are displayed, including the subscriber's IP address. Here, we also see the time remaining, indicating how long the subscription is valid. After 60 seconds, the countdown resets to 120 seconds as a new subscribed COV telegram is received and the countdown restarts. Next, we will test if the communication failure message is displayed in the reliability property when the connection is interrupted. Simply disconnect the Ethernet connection between the CC100 and the coupler, and after 60 seconds, the reliability property shows communication failure. We could configure a client mapping for digital outputs 2 through 4 similarly. However, when many objects and properties need to be configured, it is easier and faster to do so in a CSV file. To do this, we first export the client mapping. In the Browsing and Monitoring tab, select the CC100 in the database and open the Device Manager with a right-click. In the Client Mapping tab, export the client mapping to a CSV file. Open the exported file with spreadsheet software and copy the row with the already created client mapping. Adjust the cell contents so the coupler input two controls the DO2 on the CC100 and so on. Save and close the CSV file and import it again via the Device Manager in the Client Mapping tab. The configuration shows that a client mapping for the present value has been successfully created for all digital outputs on the CC100. When planning new BACnet installations, we often have the controller available, but rarely all BACnet devices. In this case, offline configuration can be done using an EDE file and subsequently transferred to the established BACnet network. EDE files facilitate exchanging BACnet device information between different manufacturers. The device information includes objects in the device or predefined values for certain properties. EDE files can be generated or imported by the Vargo BACnet configurator. An EDE file is provided as a CSV file and can be edited with spreadsheet software. The EDE import is ideal for quickly and easily creating a large number of objects, especially when the hardware is not yet available. In the browsing and monitoring view, right-click on the import point to open the EDE import window. At EDE file, open the file browser with the three points and select the EDE file provided by the manufacturer. In our case, it is the EDE file for a VAGO controller with VAGO Light Management installed. Confirm with VAGO device under Import As. An EDE file from another manufacturer would be imported as Other Device. However, now the error message Header Error Expected Keyword Version of Layout appears. This error typically occurs when the CSV file was previously opened with Excel. Excel interprets the version number as a date, converting version 2.3 to the 2nd of March, for example. We open the CSV file with a text editor, such as Notepad, and change the version number back to 2.3. The import runs error-free and the device appears under import. We can add it to the database with a right-click and then configure it as desired. As noted at the beginning, client mappings can read and write values. If possible, the read function should be preferred. However, sometimes the read function cannot be configured because special software from the respective device manufacturer is required. We demonstrate the write function with the same example as before. The goal is again to switch the first digital output of the CC100 with the first digital input of the coupler. We have removed all previously created client mappings. Open the Configure tab of the coupler and the client mapping editor in the first binary input. Find the present value of the first digital output on the CC100 and add the mapping with @WriteMap. Here we can select the priority for writing. For real values, the magnitude of the change can be specified and the write operation can be performed cyclically with cyclic sending. Values from 0 to 65,535 seconds can be entered. With 0, writing is not cyclical but only upon value change. We close the editor window, store and download the configuration into the controller. And if we now set the coupler input to true, the DU1 on the CC100 also switches to true. And that concludes the tutorial on enabling communication between devices and transferring values in building Fieldbus BACnet using the client mapping function. Please leave us a thumbs up if you found the video helpful, subscribe to the channel, and contact the VAGO Support Center if you have any questions.